Welcome to ET Auto. I'm Nabil Ahmed Khan and I have here with me Mr. Nirmal Minda, the new president of Auto Component Manufacturer Association. Welcome to ET Auto.
Thank you very much.
You have taken over as president of ACMA at a time when probably it is most interesting as well as most difficult time. What are your key things, key element that you are going to implement in your tenure? What is your mission?
I would say that this is a challenging time, and in a challenging time, you know, the industries need to be more together. And this, we are passing through a revolution now of this e-mobility. And with this resolution of the e-mobility, we need to work together with SIAM and also the government, and we need to make a clear roadmap of the implementation plan with the clear responsibility of each, you know, government, SIAM and ourselves, so that, you know, there are a lot of ambiguities now, you know, who will do what and from when. So time plan and the kind of investment, the kind of subsidy required from the government, the investment required by SIAM, the investment required by component manufacturers, I think this is the biggest challenge. And I will try to, you know, in my challenge, make ACMA more, as much as more, you know, proactive in approach.
So proactive in approach, that is going to be your key. If we look at the landscape right now, we are on a cusp of biggest ever change that we had in the last few decades. And auto component industry is at a very vulnerable stage right now. If we talk about small component makers, small company which did not have that much of technology prowess, many of them may become, you know, irrelevant. So for that, what ACMA is going to do, what is the roadmap for that? How are you working in that direction? Because of the BS6 implementation, there will be a lot of opportunity created, as well as there will be some older technology that will become obsolete. So in such a scenario, how and what is the way out?
See, first of all, with this disruption in the technology, I would not say that the many component manufacturer would disappear. No, it is not that. The component, there are some aligned technology, there are opportunities more than the disruption. In the disruption, there are opportunity. So let's look at the opportunity rather than the disruption. And as far as the changing in the norms, it continue to happen because government is, I mean, we all are very concerned on the environment, which is, you know, reducing emissions and the, you know, so-called safety. And there is, when we talk about safety, there is opportunity of airbag and starting from driver airbag to co-airbag to the side airbag and the retractable seat belt and the telematics, you know, these are all safety related products. So there are many opportunity will arrive rather than any, you know, problem in the, so the small and medium, yes, I understand that there are concern for small scale industries in, but so they will, I think, will become tier two if they are not able to invest future because the margins levels are not so high. So they will also enjoy the same business by be a tier two of some large manufacturer.
Okay, so that's how it is looking.
Will shape,
like
take a shape.
For the bigger manufacturer, the competition is going to be head on with the companies in based in developed market like Germany, Japan. Do you think it will also have the impact on large scale component makers?
I would say the foreign players, you know, when they come to, there are two ways. One is the import and second is the, you know, they come and setting a plant here. So when government of India is already, you know, making India initiative, so we all are concerned about the import. So import, we have to make our nation import-led nations. Now, as far as coming to the second part, they come and set up the factories and for the competition of the local player. So there are two, three ways. They will definitely require local players to be partners because it is very difficult for them to handle here the kind of a, you know, the complex, I would not say complex, I would say that, you know, a difficult situation of, you know, handling different tier two, tier three, the labor laws, the administrative activity, the financial, the coordination. So all that, they will need a different in local partners.
Looking at the, you know, Indian component space, we have seen mostly Indian manufacturer where getting into technical alliance or were forced to get into joint venture just to get the technology. Don't you think this, the current situation heralds a new beginning and probably gives a good message to the industry that yes, you need to be ready in terms of technology as well. And it's time we should increase investment in R&D. So what is the mood of the industry? Are they now open to investing in R&D? What has been the average expenditure in R&D and how it is looking like going forward?
So you are very right. You know, the R&D is a very key word. We have to have our own technology by whereby we create our own patent. Our own technology need to be imbibed. So for this, from ACMA, we are working with the government to heavy industries to create a technology fund to support the industries, to create a patent. And government is very open and supportive in that. They are asking us to come and bring the project so that they can work jointly and create a patent jointly, and then they can spread upon. So this is one area we are working. Secondly, the industries on their own, different part of the different component manufacturer on their own are working on the their technology and they have created their own so-called R&D cells in the different part of the country.
So what is the average
I would say right now it is 1 to 2%, but everybody is now thinking of increasing it to 3 to 4%, 5%.
That's a
good sign, you know.
If you look at the
because population. Self-reliance is very, very important for if you do not want to do, and this has happened in many of the cases.
So because you know you talk about make in India, so in most cases what happens when you sign a joint venture, many of the foreign partner close doors for your exports. And look at the last year's industry's performance. The export has not been that bullish for Indian component industry. Overall, though we grew and the auto component industry size has become over $43 billion. But still exports, the kind of expectation we have, we did not get the same kind of result. What was the reason and how do you think the industry should cope up with this this area as well?
So there are two again aspects in this. One is that if you create your own technology, you have your own patent, you have your own self-reliance, then you are free from any party to export anywhere. And the export of two kinds, one is the OEM, second is the aftermarket. Yes, we have much more aftermarket at present than the OEM, but it is increasing. The OEM is also increasing. And this depends upon the sustainability of our quality and the cost efficiency. So these are the two major concerns. But if you have a joint venture and if you optimize your cost and you reduce your cost and cost efficiency create every year on year, or then, and secondly, your quality is continuously improving and sustainable. You don't create any defect and all that. Then your foreign collaborator itself gives an opportunity to buy from you. And he also consider you that as one of the hub for his sourcing. So it is not that it is banned. Yes, most of the cases, but they also need a sustainable quality, which is a concern as of now in our industries because of so many,
So
hurdles.
For last year, even capacity utilization was not up to the mark for component industry. Overall, if you look at, how do you look at the scenario in this financial year, which we are currently training in, which is undergoing changes.
When you say capacity, means you are saying capacity, less utilization of capacity?
Yeah.
See, I would say now with the industry growing to a double digit, almost 10% and all, so capacity is going to be constrained, in fact, is going to be shortage rather than, particularly in the case of, let's say, there are customers like Maruti, customers like Honda, so whose production is increasing, rapidly.
So what was the average capacity utilization for component maker last
year? Last year it has been around 75-80%, but now I think everybody is touching around 90%, 95%. And people are now creating, Maruti is creating the additional capacity, in Gujarat. Gujarat, run this also. Everybody, all of us are setting about 60-70 manufacturers.
So what kind of investment and job creation you look forward to coming up from auto component industry in this financial year?
We are expecting a growth of around 10% as far as the
ECMA. So lesser than last year?
Yeah, a little lesser than last year. But I think with this now second half, with the stabilization of GDP, the things are getting it to the normal.
What is the specific reason for being a little conservative in terms of growth potential that you see?
There are two reasons everybody knows. One is the demonetization and the GST.
This but the government is still adamant demonetization was a very good move. So,
So I can't comment on the government. government
but you think that
no, that was not disrupted. I mean, it was a mood, you know, the kind of a mood of a general consumers for some time, you know, it get disturbed. Otherwise, things get normal after.
So because of demonetization, mainly you.
About 1 or 2 months.
Okay, so that's
that is one of the impact. Yeah.
Okay. And what kind of job creation do you expect in terms of last year versus this year?
When I say 10% growth in the top line, so I would say around with the productivity increase and all that, about 8% or so job, because about we are expecting some kind of productivity increase or low cost automation and
so
all that.
So how many people are employed currently in auto component industry, and how do you look
at that figure? I won't know very exactly at this moment.
But any rough figure if you could share?
No, honestly not. I don't know.
Okay. Thank you so
much.
Not
in my mind. Thank you.
Thank you.